DNA is all about base pairing. Adenine goes to thymine, and cytosine goes to guanine. The magic of DNA lies in the base pairing, but I think our exploration should start with some fundamental organic chemistry. Organic chemistry is very much a three-dimensional sort of thing. Carbon has four valence electrons, and those four electrons are normally used in three dimensions, which is to say they stick out in three dimensions and form three-dimensional structures. This is a molecule of alanine. You can see the three-dimensional carbon atoms. Sometimes carbon forms bonds with only three other things, and then the fourth valence electron sticks through the carbon atom and makes a cloud on the top and the bottom, pushing the three bonds out into a flat plane. When there are two carbons next to each other with this configuration, the cloud on the tops, both clouds on top see each other, and the clouds on the bottom see each other. And it makes for a half a bond on top, a half a bond on the bottom, and then a full regular covalent bond through the middle of it, and it results in a double bond. From a structural standpoint, the importance of this is that the bond does not rotate. If you have a ring structure with a lot of these types of carbons, the ring structure forms a flat ring with a cloud of electrons on the top and a cloud of electrons on the bottom. This shows the stereotypical aromatic compound, it's called, is benzene. It's a six-membered ring, it's flat, and there's a cloud on the top and a cloud on the bottom, six carbons and six hydrogens only. Nitrogen has five valence electrons. Nitrogen typically forms bonds with three other things, and then the two remaining electrons make a cloud, and the cloud is actually much bigger than the bonds, and the cloud pushes compounds with nitrogen into pyramids. Again, looking at the alanine, this is an amino acid or an amino group, and you see that the nitrogen forms a pyramidal structure. Nitrogen does a trick similar to what carbon does. Sometimes nitrogen will form a bond with three other things, but the remaining electrons will make an orbital right through the middle of the nitrogen and push these three constituents out onto a flat plane. So nitrogen also will form flat planar structures. And furthermore, these flat planar structures can be joined into an aromatic ring and make things like this. To properly understand the structure of DNA, I think we need to take a little bit of a look at hydrogen bonding. Hydrogen bonding is things like we have two nitrogen compounds. These are in an aromatic planar state, and each of them has a hydrogen. These hydrogens have an electron cloud that goes out this way, and they share. It's like my image of it is that the electron clouds like each other, and that's about all there is to it. The hydrogen bond is very much related to the geometry of the situation. If these two molecules are lined up properly, they make a very weak bond. If they're not lined up, they don't make a bond really at all. Water is like massively hydrogen bonded, but the massive numbers of hydrogen bonds are extremely weak. A lot of the very weird behavior in water comes from the hydrogen bonds, but the hydrogen bonds are constantly breaking and forming and breaking and forming. In DNA, the structure is set. The hydrogen bonds work because they all work together. You can't have just one hydrogen bond. The hydrogen bonds are all tied together, and that's what makes the bond strong. Let's take a look at a carbonyl. Some of them are based upon a carbonyl oxygen. Again, this is a planar situation, and there are two electrons that go out this way and this way, and these two clouds that go out this way and this way, and this guy will make a bond with another one here. So the carbonyl oxygen is also set up for hydrogen bonds. Hydrogen bonds are sort of like the electron clouds gently liking each other. It's not a very strong bond at all. Okay, adenine. Let's take a look at adenine. Adenine is flat. The ribose goes on this part. The hydrogen bonds come against this part. And adenine wants to form a relationship with thymine. So the two hydrogen bonds are, and notice how geometrically they're nailed down together. These are not, if this was twisted, these would not be strong, but together they're stronger. And of course the DNA has a lot of hydrogen bonds. Guanine and cytosine form a similar relationship. Notice how guanine and cytosine have three hydrogen bonds, and adenine and thymine only have two. And then this is maybe a little bit weird, but I made a transparency of this. I mean, this is gonna might sound a little bit silly, but if you turn this over, I don't see any intuitively obvious reason why you shouldn't be able to just turn it over. You can't turn it over. The bases, as they're lined up, are always facing the same direction.